song. There's a fire that burns inside, a fire that burns inside. Nothing can stop us. We'll be running through the night with a fire that burns inside, a fire that burns inside.
God did many great and wonderful things for us in 2011 at Cornerstone Church. What a great year we had. God proved himself to be faithful to us. I think one of the greatest highlights of the year for me was Easter Sunday. I always believe that God spoke a promise to me that we would have a double portion in the land, that 1,000 will become 2,000. And did you know that on Easter Sunday, we had almost 2,200 people here at Cornerstone Church? That was a fulfillment of the promise that God spoke to me, but you know what? I believe it was a partial fulfillment. I believe God is going to continue to grow us and increase us numerically, financially, and spiritually. I'm looking forward to 2012. God has saved the best until now.
Here we are, recapping what God did in 2011. In January of 2011, during the Daniel fast, God spoke to me and gave me an agenda for the women of this past year, and he called it Princess Warrior. The highlight of this year was seeing hundreds of women gather together to be challenged not to just love God, follow God, have a passion for God, but to have an uncivilized passion, an uncivilized commitment to his will, and having a desire and a decision to never turn back. This year we saw women respond to that call, and I want to thank God at this time and in this moment for what he has done.
My highlight of the year for Kids on the Rock is Easter Sunday, because we had the largest attendance, we had the most visitors, and more kids gave their heart to the Lord that day than any other day in 2011. But what really topped it off for me was during the services, there's just a strong sense that the kids were grasping the truth, that they have eternal life and are saved because they know that Jesus died and rose again for them. What could be better than that? Another thing I like about Easter was it came the day after our infamous egg drop, which did not go as planned. But it just reminded me that even when our best laid plans fail, God's plan still prevails and he still wins.
I have two highlights for this year for Ignited. The first one is how we revamped our discipleship process. We wanted to create a program for all of our students to really effectively connect with God. And we created a class called the Exchange Class, where all the kids can get discipled and get to know Christ in a deeper way. It's powerful. The second highlight was Awaken. The first one this spring, this past spring, we had in Detroit 2,000 young women really be ministered to, and it was an incredible time and just seeing God move. And then we, for the very first time, took Awaken National to Colorado Springs, and there was 1,200 girls there, and it was just an incredible move of God as well. And we're just seeing great things happen through Awaken Conference and here locally and now going around the country as well. And so we're just so thanking the Lord for all that he did this year.
My highlight for the year for Momentum was when we did our two hot weeks. These were 2 weeks in a row where we were doing big services. And on the final night, we were going to give away a car. And we had some attendance goals, we had some first-time visitor goals, and we really wanted the car to go to someone who really deserved it. and we had all three of those goals were met. We had 100 people in attendance, which was a record for us. We had 19 first-time visitors, and the car was given away to a girl who really deserved the vehicle. God answered every single one of our prayers, and we really had an incredible night at Momentum, and we knew the future was bright from here on out.